I'm Chang Liu Liu, an assistant professor in the Robotics Institute here at Carnegie Mellon. And my main research area is on robot safety and how to make robots safely and efficiently collaborate with humans in industrial environments. This is the industrial robot that we are currently doing research on. It is from FANUC. It was usually used in those heavy-duty production lines, doing some welding and heavy-duty tasks. And usually they're put into the cages. There's a huge shift of emphasis from massive production to massive customization. We also want those robots to be on flexible assembly lines so that they can collaborate with humans to improve efficiency and productivity in the final assembly.
So one of the cool things about this project is this was a collaborative end-to-end project where we did knitting design, we did sensor calibration, and we put the whole thing on a robot. And that was all down to three different faculty members and a whole host of different students working together.
In the tactile sensing community, there has been a long-standing demand of having a nice large-scale tactile skin to cover the very complicated surface of multiple robots. Jim and I work on designing the sensor, calibrate the sensor, and then we work with Chang Liu to optimize the system.
Can we take this technology, machine knitting, and use it to make a sensor which is suitable for deployment on robots?
And make the surface a sensor such that we can sense the contact and the force. I was like, okay, that's a great idea. My robot actually need that. My student created a very clever way to calibrate the skin with respect to the robot. For each touch, we'll know what location it is on the skin, and also we know what location it is on the robot. Then we kind of map these two things together, and also we can do this similarly for the force calibration. And after that, we can then use the skin as a very powerful sensor.
My name is Bo. I'm a master of ECE student here at CMU. The tactile skin is attached to the robot. It allows us to interact with the robot in a more natural way. The skin is being calibrated to localize the contact and determine the actual force that is applied on the skin. The skin can accurately localize where the human contact is. As you can see, it gives the location and the pressure.
We can do this safety modification of the trajectory. Whenever there's a touch on one direction, the robot will cancel out all the velocity on that direction, but still try its best to continue or follow the rest of the trajectory.
There's a large potential of our sensors to cover not only the industrial robot Chang Liu is using, but also the robots in other factories, or the robots that work with humans at home, in hospitals, in warehouse, and generally everywhere.
So this is an example of what can happen when you have people with expertise in the whole robotics pipeline, from the fundamental materials to electrical design and characterization, modeling, sensing, and control. When everybody's working together, you can have these very satisfying projects where you go from a very small idea to really seeing it on an actual robot, proving out the idea.